Watch it grow, occupational options, get some flow and some more. Learn to rap for the jack. Fucking men in the meantime, go ahead and pump it back. It's my Regal Royal flow, my James Bond bounce. That 007, that 62 on my count. I'm a
happy belated birthday to your boy, 50 Cent, a.k.a. Kanan, a.k.a. the troll god, man. But yeah, happy belated birthday to him. He turned 44 yesterday, and he is a great inspiration to the show Power, and he's done so much for so many people, man. But happy belated birthday to your boy. Let's begin the video. Now, today we're going to be talking about Power Season 6, What to Expect. Now, this is the What to Expect video for Season 6. If you haven't checked out my last video, I did the Power Season 6 trailer, official trailer recap. So check that out if you haven't seen it. Now, we're pretty much just going to go over the key storylines and things that we should be expecting in this next season. I'm going to remind you of things that we probably forgot that is going to be very important in this next season. So leave your theories, comments, everything down below, and let's get to it. Now, in Power Season 6, we can expect Maria to play a vital role. As I always told you guys, these small characters, they always come back. Now, they've been showing us Maria numerous of times. She's just not going to be shown for nothing. Technically, in real life, her case is nothing. She has no type of evidence. But we know with this show, they're going to try to do something to make her a key player in the game. So we're going to see, with the help of Cooper Sacks, he's destined to take out Ghost and to finally prove himself. And that's exactly what he wants to do. So we can expect this Maria to be very powerful in this next season. She's going to play a vital role, in my opinion. The people that she is connected to, maybe we'll see them people. Those same people that Ghost was talking about in the very first episode of Power. Maybe they are the ones that's going to come for Ghost. We're going to have to wait and see. But it's just things with Maria, I just feel like they're not going to keep showing her for no reason. And also, we can expect your boy Joe Proctor to be back. And of course, he's going to still try to support Ghost. But we also know he still has that laptop. It's a key element also in this next season. So pay close attention to Joe Proctor's actions, his behaviors, because trust and believe, he has a dirty background. His family is dirty, and you best believe he has that laptop for insurance. Now, we know that the evidence on the laptop is admissible in court. If this was real life, it doesn't prove anything. Even though we have Tommy Egan on there killing Ruiz and pretty much confessing to killing Lobos, it's still admissible in court. I don't know how Joe Proctor is going to use his laptop, but it will play a vital role. You already know it's going to play a role, and Joe Proctor is very smart. Will he betray Ghost? Will he stick to his side? From the trailers, it does seem like Joe Proctor is still there for Ghost. You know what I'm saying? It seems like he's still there trying to be there for him. But we all know, you can't trust nobody. Remember what they say. Trust is dead. Loyalty is dead. That's the whole themes of Season 6. So even though Joe Proctor has a good heart and he wants to protect Ghost, Ghost must watch himself. Joe Proctor has more of a motive to cross over Tommy Egan. But at the same time, he's connected to a murder. And that murder is Bailey. So Joe Proctor has to be very smart this season. I've seen being very smart, but being watched at the same time. You know, you already know Ghost is going to watch him. Will Tommy Egan watch him? Because that's the person that should be watching him. But I'm eager to see how we, you know, see what Joe Proctor does and see his family. You already know they're going to be up to something. Now, Tommy and Lakeisha, we can expect them to rise to the top, to have their moment, or we may say. Keisha's been wanting this. Now, I've been reading the comment section on the trailer recap. Everybody's saying that Keisha wants to be Tasha so bad. She looks like a G. You know what I'm saying? She looks like she's about that life. Well, in Season 6, we're going to find out if she is about that life. This is going to be her season to shine, to show everyone that she can handle the job. Now, we already know history repeats itself, that if Lakeisha messes up, it's not going to be good for her. You know what I'm saying? I have a feeling in this next season, we can expect everything to be cool at first. Of course, she's going to be motivating Tommy to go ahead and screw over Ghost and Tasha because she wants to be at the top spot. She wants what Tasha has so badly. And she's also tired of Tasha screwing her over, which is very understandable. But I think Keisha is biting off more than she can chew. And she's going to find out very quickly that this lifestyle is a little bit too dangerous for her. She has kids. She has a liability, which makes her a liability because I still to this day believe if that pressure is put on her, she gonna slip. And if she even slips one bit, it's night-night time. It's Christmas canceled. You already know. Now, the question is, who is she pointing this gun at? As I explained in the recap trailer, we don't really know. It could be anybody. Terry, I mean, it could be Tommy Egan. It could be Ghost or Tasha. I mean, it could be somebody else, you know. But Keisha is going to be challenged in this next season. We can expect her to finally answer those questions about if she's hard or not and if she's up for the challenge. Now, the whole theme we've been hearing about is Ghost Tommy, Tommy Ghost. Of course, we want to see it. They're going to, you know, give us that whole rivalry between the two. These two are brothers and they're going to keep going at it over and over again. They've been doing it since the very first season. Now, they're making it very big. And, you know, this season, of course, because what happened, you know, with Angela and everything like that, with Ghost Lion, these two are going to be going at it. But in my opinion, I don't think they're going to be going at it the whole season. I think it's going to be a break. I honestly think these two are going to squash it for a brief moment, at least. I think they're going to have to work together. These guys known each other forever, and I can see them squashing it. I mean, just look at this. These guys was dancing. They've been in scenes together. This is, you know, them filming season 6 right here. Them dancing all cool and shit. I'm telling y'all, do not think that they're going to be beefing the whole season. That trailer that they showed us, that could probably be from episode 1 to 5 or 1 to 8. They're not going to show us every single thing. From the trailer, it looks like it's going to be Tommy versus Ghost the whole season. I don't think that's going to happen. I think these two are going to squash it somehow, some way. And eventually, they're going to work together and possibly take out Dre. That's what I think. I think this, you know, the game plan is to always take out Dre at the end of the day because I think he's being overlooked. They think they probably got him in the bag, but I don't think so. But this whole Ghost and Tommy thing, as of right now, it does seem very big. It seems like it's something that's going to blow over, in my opinion. I say, and I've seen some of the comments, I believe some of y'all, man, that they probably going to squash it. But I think we all know Ghost. He a type of person that will squash it, make it seem like it's cool, then at the end, take out Tommy. But we're going to see if that happens. Also, we can expect Kate Egan to return in Power Season 6. And I've been reading the comic section. A lot of y'all really watched this trailer. Y'all seen some things that I possibly missed, you know. And that's Kate Egan's house. Now, the rumor is her house was shot up. And that was one of the reasons that Tommy was very mad. He was very angry. You hear him in the trailer talking about, did you think I wouldn't find out or something like that. Now, as you see, this is one of the pictures from the trailer. We see the guys coming in with that gun. Like I said, these people, my subs told me this is Kate Egan's house. This is just a theory. It's a theory. Do you think that Tommy had messed up? What if he messed up with the Serbians? You know what I'm saying? What if he messed up with the Italians? And they coming for Tommy. They coming for blood. You already know the Italians don't play. The Serbians don't play. And how many times has Jason warned Tommy? Numerous of times. So we're going to find out if Kate Egan survives. I think she's going to survive, you know, if this is even her house or whatever. But if this is Kate Egan's spot, man, that's going to be sad. You know what I'm saying? That's going to be very sad. And Tommy's going to have to, he's going to have to retaliate. Now, we already know Ghost won't do nothing like this. So it has to be Jason or the Italians. Now, speaking of Jason, Jason wants Ghost out of the picture. He's been wanting Ghost out of the picture because of the history. He doesn't like Ghost. You know what I'm saying? This goes back from the very beginning. He does not like Ghost at all. The Serbians don't like him because what Ghost did. Now, Tommy's going to have to make a choice because now he's being put, you know, in the spotlight. Is he going to finish the job? You know, he's going to be telling Tommy that, look, Ghost is out there. You need to go finish the job. So once again, we can expect Tommy Egan to have to choose, you know, and have to make that decision of killing and taking out Ghost. The way he's looking is looking like, man, I don't want to do it. Maybe they did squash that beef. And now Tommy's like, man, I don't, you know what I'm saying? We cool now. I don't really want to go out and take out my boy. We going to find out, man. We going to find out. But they say loyalty is dead. So this time, will Tommy finally finish the job? I think something big is going to happen. They want Ghost dead. And best believe they're going to try everything to get him to be dead. Now, your boy Tariq is returning and he's making mistakes. We can expect him to get hemmed up by your boy Vincent. Tariq is stupid because he's stealing and he's doing dumb things. And this season, he's going to be all over the place. Everyone is going to be making all these Twitter posts and all these different jokes about how dumb he is, because he's just, the kid has everything, you know what I'm saying? But he's still going to decide to do dumb shit, stealing product, you know, losing that trust. A guy like Vincent, you know, pretty much gave you an opportunity and you want to steal from him. It's going to be bad. My question for you is, how is all this going to play out? Because you already know this is going to happen. And that is that Tommy Egan is going to know about this. Vincent is going to find out the truth that Tariq is connected to Tommy, in my opinion. And he's going to find out that Tariq is Ghost's son, which, in my opinion, may start a war, which means that Ghost and Tommy are going to have to save Tariq, which means they have to team up together once again. It's so much stuff going, man. They're going to have to team up, in my opinion. Now, another theme is Tariq Ghost. Ghost Tariq. If you've been watching my videos, you already know that I've always been talking about it, because your boy Tommy Egan talked about it on a show. He said that the themes of power, of father killing son, son killing father, we're going to see that once again. You know what I'm saying? We've seen Kanan kill Shine. We seen Tommy kill Tony Terezzi, bitch ass Tony Terezzi at that. Will we see it again? I really hope not. I don't want Ghost getting killed by Tariq at all. And I don't want to see Ghost killing Tariq. I mean, I know a lot of y'all want that boy gone. I don't want to see him killing the kid, but I don't want Ghost dying. Tariq is going to have to choose between his father and his uncle Tommy. What is he going to do? Now, we know Tariq is very childish. He makes a lot of mistakes. But in the past, you know, he was very close to Kanan. And he made the decision last season to take out Kanan, to, you know, agree to set Kanan up. And he was very close to Kanan. In my opinion, I feel like he was more closer to Kanan than he was to Tommy. You guys let me know about that. But at the end of the day, yes, Tariq is childish. But when it comes to his family, I think he'll choose his family over Tommy, which in the long run, I think Tariq has his own game plan. I talked about it in the recap about him playing chess and being smart and tricking Ghost. But I do think the boy is smart enough to know not to pick Tommy over his father. But we gonna see. Now, Tasha, we can expect her to be Tasha, and that's to dog out Ghost, to blame him for a lot of different things. Now, when it comes to these two, I always say both parties play a part. It ain't just Ghost's fault. It ain't just Tasha's fault. It's both of their fault for all the things that has happened. We all know Ghost wanted out the drug game, but Tasha didn't want him to. And she's going to tell him, you took everything from me. Everything. Now, when I first saw that trailer, man, I thought she was talking to Angela, but when you think about it, she was talking to Ghost, because Ghost is the one that took out Terry Silver. He's the one that, in Tasha's opinion, took her away from her family and everything. Tasha loved Terry Silver, apparently. If you guys don't remember him, here he is right here. Terry Scootball Silver, just in case you forgot. Yes, this guy right here. Tasha loved him, but he played her. But anyway, Tasha feels like Ghost screwed her over. And that makes, you know, Tasha to have motive. Maybe Tasha says, you know what, I'm tired of Ghost. So we can expect Tasha to make that decision this next season to say, you know what, I'm going to finally do what is needed to be done. Now, I know a lot of people say Tasha will never screw Gross over. She'll never screw the father of her kids over. But loyalty is dead. We gonna find out, man. I hope Tasha doesn't. I really hope she doesn't do that to your boy. Now, the theme of that trailer was, in my opinion, Ghost versus everybody. You know what I'm saying? This dude got enemies. I mean, watching the trailer, you damn near think Ghost is gonna die because everybody's after him. Everybody has a problem with Ghost. Everybody. Tasha, Tariq, Tommy, the Serbians, Cooper Sacks, Rashad Tate, Dre. Boy got a million enemies. Everyone is after Ghost. They making it very obvious that, you know, he can die. Of course he could. Anybody can die, but it's like it's almost too obvious. I just don't think he's going to go out like that. And as I was telling you about Rashad Tate, we can expect him to come back. We can expect, in my opinion, Rashad Tate to survive. I don't think he's going to die. I think he's going to survive this, run his little campaign, and just lead the way and maybe get that spinoff. Now, that's the rumor that he's going to be getting his own spinoff. We gonna see, man. But in my opinion, I believe Rashad Tate dies. He doesn't seem that much of a threat to Ghost far as killing him. But we just never know when it comes to Rashad Tate. Now, this whole Angela thing, I had the wrong subtitles. Ghost did say I didn't kill her. YouTube subtitles is horrible. But anyway, this red dress you see, one of my subs told me, and I kind of remembered, I was thinking the same thing, that reminds me of the same red dress that Angela first had on when Ghost and her saw each other again. And it's possible that it is. But anyway, in my opinion, I think this is just a ghost. I don't think Angela is going to make it. We can expect to find out the truth for sure, but I think Angela is gone and Ghost is hallucinating just like he did with Raina Past. And he's going to be seeing shit. You know what I'm saying? It's going to change him mentally. And he ain't going to be the same. Just like with Raina. This dude is going to be all over the place. He got everybody against him. Angela possibly is going to die. And then we're going to have her sister on his ass. Trust and believe, I ain't forgot about her. Y'all, you know, I made this video, just in case y'all didn't see it. Angela's sister, Paz, she's going to be very pissed off about her sister. She told Ghost she'll kill him herself. I don't know if she's going to play a key factor, seeing that she's not going to be in this season a lot. But remember, small characters, they always have a big impact. So we're going to see what happens with that. Now, Dre will be a problem. We can expect him to continue to be a problem, even in witness protection. Now, if Angela dies, that kind of messes up the whole confession thing, because I believe he signed that off on Angela. I mean, I guess he did sign it when he was in that van, but it was an agreement with Angela. But besides all that, Dre is going to be a problem. It's possible that Ghost could work with Dre because he's going to feel like he needs someone, seeing that everybody's going to be against him, including bitch-ass Dre. But, you know, Ghost, he has that weakness, and that's the always make allies. So we gonna see how that plays out. I feel like Dre is still enemy number one, and he needs to be taken out. And I think that they're gonna figure out a way to finally take his ass out. I don't care who it is. It can be Tariq, it can be Tommy, it can be Ghost, it can be Cooper Sacks, it can be Tasha, it can be Keisha. I don't care. Somebody better smoke him. Take out Dre. Trust me, he has to go. Now, if he does survive, I'm not going to be shocked, because we saw what happened in season 5. We saw that Max Payne performance. This dude jumping out a window, surviving. I'm not surprised anymore when it comes to Dre. But we going to see, man. Last couple things that we can expect. Of course, we can expect 2Bits to come back better than ever, but he's going to have to watch his back from Dre. And, man, this is the season, y'all. Will Ghost die? That is the biggest question for season 6. Will he make it? Will he survive? In my opinion, I really don't know. I can't even tell you. I couldn't even make a prediction of the end and the power, because I really, honestly, do not know if this man is going to survive. They were making it very obvious that everyone is against him. Like I told you guys, that trailer can be episode 1 to 5. They're not going to show us everything in the season, but I think it's very obvious that he is enemy number one in everyone else's eyes. He is the problem, but maybe that's just too obvious for him to go out like that. And if he does go out, trust and believe, he ain't going out without a fight. He's going to bang it out. Trust and believe, man. We got to see that Ghost from season 2 performance. Ghost knows what he has to do to take out everybody and to fix this. But is he willing to do it? That is the question. I do believe it's going to be a plot twist with Tariq, Tommy, Tasha, and Lakeisha. And also, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, the whole laptop, Maria and Joe Proctor, pay close attention to all that. Trust me, pay close attention to it. It's going to come up somehow, some way. But you guys let me know, man. I gave y'all a long video. I try to give y'all a long informative video, something that I haven't done in a while. It's power season, man. Y'all might as well get ready. We're going to talk about all these storylines, man. It's about to get crazy. So leave your theories, comments, everything down below, and I will continue to bring you more power content in the future. But it's your boy, Mark Dark. I'm out. Peace.